quiere ser dueño de todo. No me dejen en paz, nuestro cabrón. Lo nuestro cabrón. Uno para y lo estoy borracho los dos. Si viene conmigo, pide ese control. Pide control. This is Tamagotchi. 12 veces tú me oaks. I'm making bread. Sound like Pavarotti. My bags and leaves. You can't get it out. This is not my scene. Vamos pa' Miami. Fill up my waistline. I'm in LA for hours away, just hit me on FaceTime. Feeling so good, feeling so good, singing the bass line. Your body is on me, you're touching up on me at the same time, same time. You with somebody, or are you cool? I want your body, you want me too. I see it coming, I come for you. Need you around me, I know you do. Ando de gira y todos me sigan, los chicos me quieren tocar. Tengo dinero y ando soltero, dime lo que quieres comprar. Aquí está muy frío, nos vamos de sigo, ¿dónde quieres ir a volar? Algo sencillo con un cigarrillo, me dice que quiere. This time I got you, 12 veces tú me walkie. I'm making friends, sound like Pavarotti. My bags and leaves, you can't get it out. This is not my scene, vamos pa' Miami. Fill up my waistline. I'm in LA for hours away, just hit me on FaceTime. Feeling so good, singing the bass line. Your body is on me, you're touching up on me at the same time, at the same time. You with somebody, or are you cool? I want your body, you want me too. I see it coming, I come for you. Need you around me, I know you do. Is this what you want? I'm sure I ain't tryna front no more. Ain't seen you in months or more. You're all that I want for sure. Is this what you want? I'm sure I ain't tryna front no more. Ain't seen you in months or more. You're all that I want for sure. Tamagotchi, 12 buses through Milwaukee. I'm making bread, sound like Pavarotti. My bags and lean, you can't get it off me. This is not my scene, vamos pa' Miami. Quieres ser dueño de todo. No me dejen par, nuestro cabrón. Nuestro cabrón.
When writing and producing Tamagotchi, it was funny because I had a bunch of like Neptune samples, and then I had met Chad a few years back. It was funny, we made like a bunch of songs actually, and then we got really cool, and I was like, yeah, I got all these like Neptune drums, and he was just like, let's use them. Probably like 2 or 3 years later, Brock, who was on A&R, was like, yo, Pharrell's down to work. I was like, cool. And so I like flew out to Miami, and yeah, we made like, I made a song, and he really liked it. And then after that one, he was like, how long are you gonna stay here? And I was like, well, only like 2 days. He's like, extend your flight, like we gotta make 5 more. Tamagotchi was the last one that we made, so I got like 4 other ones. But yeah, I thought Tamagotchi was perfect for the album.
I know you do. Ando de gira y todo me sigan, los chicos me quieren tocar.
I think the reason I put Spanish in Tamagotchi is probably because I was just in Miami and like everyone was talking to me in Spanish, like the driver and you know the hotel, everybody speaks Spanish. And I was like, you know, everybody knows that all the, like the reggaeton artists are like in Miami, so it's like just felt right, I don't know.
Fill up my waistline.
What do I want them to take away from Tamagotchi? I want them to run it back. Like, yeah, listen to it a few times. I would just hope people would be, they would get some type of enjoyment and some inspiration in whatever way, I guess. Inspire them to have a better day, or I don't know, some. You know what? I'm gonna preview how Tamagotchi sounds in the club tonight because my friend's DJing, but in the car it hits crazy. But it's gonna hit crazy at the club too, for sure.
Thumb making bread, sound like Pavarotti. My bag's in lean, you can't get it off me. This not my scene, vamos pa Miami. CS1 release. I miss my girl, it's time to hit the streets. I want to check my dial, get some vitamin C. You won't believe what happened to me. I the cold ivy out of consciousness if I ever slipped it. And I woke up in an ambulance. My baby spoke to me. He kissed me, now I love his dopamine. I tried to go to sleep, but my brain on 2CP. You won't believe what happened to me. Cold ivy, out of consciousness. If I ever slipped it, I pick on, move at high speed now. That's my song, let me hear that bounce. Latin boy for the color brown. Shacking with jeans for a grandma brown. But these shit walls with the porcelain tile. 28-6, now they duck uptown. If I'm down, would you help me out? If I'm down, would you help me out?
On the song Invincible, me and Daniel Caesar, we became friends over the pandemic. And then one day we're just like, you know, I didn't really plan on making music, we were just chilling. And then I started playing the chords to Invincible. And then we put it down, and then we ended up making it like an 8-minute song. And then left it alone for probably like 6 months or something like that. And I was like, yo, he had the stems. I was like, yo, send me those stems. Like, I think I can make it into a song for my album. He was like, yeah. So he sent them, and then it was, it was like an 8-minute demo that turned into a song.
24 hours after CS1 release, I miss my girl, it's time to hit the
song Invincible definitely started off more of like in a rock lane, and honestly, I had it on a, like I had made 100 songs for the album, and when I was listening back to back, I was like, dang, this needs a little more, like, needs to pick up a little bit somehow, but I didn't want to like speed it up, I just wanted to like put some fast drums on it, so I just told my homie Carter, he had the MPC, and I was just like, yo, just like some Chicago, just some juke, so yeah, it was cool. I think my favorite lyric is the chorus, if I were to go, tell me would you notice me? Because it was like a, if you watch the video, it's kind of like this little concept going on. Basically you like get really messed up and then the next day you have to get an IV to recuperate. Because everyone has you know, those mornings where they're super hungover and they're like, man, what did I do all that? Why did I talk that much or you know, whatever. And I guess those actions are probably rooted in some sort of like desperation or like attention that you want. The best place to listen to that song is probably in headphones. But I don't know, I mean, it sounds good everywhere, but headphones is tight, because especially on a plane, when you're going up, you're trying to get some altitude somehow, going up a hill, I don't know. Yeah, like Rocky running up the steps or something, I don't know. And that's what the end of that song feels like to me, like it's ending. It would have been a nice closer for the album, but nah, I picked another one. Tell me what you know. What's up, MTV? I'm Omar Apollo, and I'm about to push play. What song reminds me of my childhood? Probably She Move Her Body Like a Cyclone, because me and my sister would dance to that like a crazy amount. And Sensual Seduction reminds me of my childhood, too. Snoop Dogg. What song do I listen to before? No, probably like Future, definitely, or Drake. Yeah, pretty much. Well, Drake is gonna be jaded. Yes, I'm hurting. Yes, I'm jaded. And then I don't know. The Future, probably. I don't know. Face Shot or something. The song I can't stop listening to right now is "Saving All My Love for You" by Whitney Houston. Something about the melody. Something about saying "saving all of my love for you" is so dramatic. I love that. You know me. My songs are very dramatic. So. Depends if you want to be sad or if you want to move on. If you want to sulk in it, then yeah, probably like some Woody Gun 3, Ain't It Hard. That's the one. That's sad. It's a really sad song. Song to listen to when I'm in love. Wow, so intimate of a question. Lovers Rock, Sade, yeah. No, that's the song I'll listen to. Girls and Boys by Blur.
Girls are like boys, are like girls, are like boys.
It's a driving song. Like driving, like it's not like driving physically, but like it's emotionally driving. Probably my unreleased music I listen to very loudly in the car, like way too loud. I think I need to start watching how loud I play things, because my phone is telling me I'm playing things too loud. So I'm trying to be a quieter listener, but yeah, if it's my song, I have it cranked all the way up. I don't care. Yeah. Go-to karaoke song is California Dreamin', because it's in my key. Favorite throwback track has gotta be Breaking Benjamin or 3 Days Grace. My brother was really into alternative stuff, so I knew about all that world. One time the guy from 3 Days Grace, I guess before I started working there, came in a guitar center and was like playing his songs, and someone was like, oh, I love that song. He was like, I wrote it. I was like, yo. He's like, I love you guys. I was like, wow, we just met, but that's amazing. I love you too. Hey MTV, I'm Omar Apollo and I'm gonna take you behind the gram. That was at the Salt Flats, where that Madonna video was at. I was there with some friends, and I have like a fire guy. He's like, yo, you have to play with my flamethrower before you leave. And then we just
shooting it like crazy, and it was the best decision I made in like a week probably.
Well, that was when I used to gig, I used to dance. I was in my little mariachi suit. That was ballet folklorico, which is Mexican folk ballet. I used to go practice every week. One of the dances we used to close the night out with was the raspa, which is a very known song in Mexico. It's like taran, 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 taran. Yeah, I don't need to do it, but you know. If you know, you know.
I was in New York getting a chopped cheese, and I was wearing a very neon pink shirt, and I just really knew it was gonna look cool, so I told my friend, I was like, yo, you have to click me up. And we stood there for like 5 minutes trying to get the right photo, and the guy was just looking at us, but it was tight. Okay, yeah, that is me in my mom's salon. She's a hairstylist. And that is me and my brothers and my dad.
I grew up going to the salon. That's kind of my first introduction to like reggaeton and stuff. My mom would sometimes put highlights on me or dye my hair. I was her little like test dummy. I always had fresh haircuts, always clean, always groomed.
Oh, that was a few days ago in rehearsal, and I'm obsessed with skylights, and there was a huge skylight, and I told my drummer, I said, dude, get me in action. I'm gonna just be walking around, just catch me in action. It's tight. My friend Najee designed those, and they're the coolest pants ever. I've always wanted to make clothes. I've always been a fan of like silhouettes, you know, getting samples and seeing how things turn out. And we've just been making a bunch of samples ever since.
That was on set for the Tamagotchi music video. And I have my little iced out Tamagotchi. I have a jeweler who made the Tamagotchi for me. Yeah, I just told him about it and he was like super down. He actually like said that he loves me. So I was like, wow. He's like, I love you guys. I was like, wow, we just met, but that's amazing. I love you too.
Thanks for watching. Bye, MTV.